Hey there, Carla here from Documenting the Journey. I am going to open today the October sub box from Cloth and Paper. I have been in and out of the sub box all year in 2024. A friend of mine gifted me a HP mini disc system from Cloth and Paper at the beginning-ish of the year. I don't know exactly what day. Or what month, I mean. But I used it all in May, and I really liked the layout. But I struggled with the actual disc system of it because it was just really floppy for me. And I didn't know if that was just the way I don't know. I'd never used discs prior to this, so I didn't know if that was the way that I was just using it or if it was just kind of what it was. And so I actually did something a little bit different. So I've been in and out of it. So I did something a little bit different with these inserts, and I'll show you here in a little bit. But anyways, that was my little spiel of I've been in and out of the sub boxes. I paused the boxes for quite a while just due to financial things. My AC and my furnace went out, so that was a hot mess. But what I've loved that they have done recently is they're giving you the theme and showing you what's inside the boxes while you still have time to sign up. And this is the October box, and the theme was note-taking and annotations, and I had to get it. So I did get it. All of that stuff earlier was me to say I got it in HP mini size. Go ahead and just kind of look and see what is in here. I'm going to set that aside because I don't know what's in that, and I don't know if non-members, I don't know how that works. Okay, so I also do the ones with the pen subscription, but let's go ahead and just open all of this. And I like these little bags. They're really useful. Let's go ahead and I'm going to refer to this little product guide. I will be the first to admit that I very rarely will use anything in this envelope. I know plenty of people love these types of things, but I don't decorate the inside pockets of my planners, and I just honestly don't utilize these things very often. I might keep them for a little while because like this I will never use, so I know that I'm gonna chuck or just re-gift. This, I guess it's a pen test sheet. But this I feel like is really interesting because this is not the same material as their paper. And so you can test it for like the color, but as far as smearing and stuff, I feel like it's not good enough like test. So I'll set that aside. Again, this is just pocket deco and then like a little journaling card. This one says footnote. And noun, a note of reference, explanation, or comment usually placed at below the text on a printed page, so a definition. And then a month card, which again I won't use because I utilize my monthly calendar, but I know a lot of people actually love these types of things. So let's go ahead and open up the dashboard first. Marginala, I don't know how to say that. I don't really utilize dashboards a lot either, just again, because of the way I plan. I don't plan with like a lot of decoration, but I do a lot of decoration in my journal. So for me, it's two totally different things. So here's what I was gonna say about my disc system. So I love this size. It is very similar, almost exact, to a B6 size, which is what my bullet journal and journal is right now. I did a lot of Googling on sizes, and I found out that this size can also fit in a personal size rings. So what I did with my inserts is I cut off right here where the discs start, and I punched it. And they fit in my personal rings perfectly. And this I actually really like because it doesn't like move around on me, and it just stays there and it lays flat, and it's easy for me. I don't know, rings are easier for me. So if I were to use that dashboard, I would cut the discs part off and just add it into my rings. I'm probably not going to use it because it's more of a cream, whereas everything else in my planner is white. But I know a lot of people love these dashboards. And it is very pretty with the bookshelf. I actually do like the bookshelf. So these inserts I will absolutely use because I take a lot of notes. I do have a lot of note space in a work planner. I was considering taking this to work, even though it's a disc bound and I don't really love discs, like I just said, because they're super floppy like this. But this is a bunch of note page from Handy Forms that I've gotten in the HP mini size. I have the grid, I have the blank, and then I have the dot grid. So I was actually just thinking of taking this to work because I can easily just carry it around and I can pop these in here. But this is like a Cornell style note page that has like a grid space over here, a space for a date up here, and then just a column with lines here. And the lines match up with the grid space, which I really appreciate. So that I know I will definitely absolutely use. So I really like these. And then I don't know how many sheets you get. I feel like a lot of their stuff has 30 sheets maybe. And here's an example of how you can use it. You can use it with like one subject here and then more explanation and then another subject. And you can use these for meetings as well, or you can use these for goals and action items and expanding on your goals. So these I love and I will absolutely use. We also have some correction tape, which is interesting because my daughter just asked me for like the whiteout stuff and I told her I didn't have any. So I am curious about how well this works because I did see on the reel that Cloth and Paper had, I don't remember if it was a reel or what it was, but when they used it, the tape didn't like actually stick to the paper. So I'm going to try it real quick. So, not the greatest. I had to go over it 3 times because the edge of this kept scraping off the middle part of the whiteout, but it's, I think, cream based. I know, I just got it. Hang on. So let me try it here on one of their inserts. So it worked better on that, but it definitely does not match their paper, which I don't think most whiteouts match the papers, but it definitely worked better and it didn't really like not stick on the page. So I liked those. So that I will definitely use. Page flags. One of my friends sent me an email saying, maybe it's in this member access card, or she actually said that they sent out an email saying the page flags didn't come in time for the box, so they sent these sticky notes instead. And I don't remember, I don't recall seeing the email, so if I'm saying any incorrect information, I'm very sorry. But they sent these instead, and so they are the same ones that they've had. I don't know about the color, but they're the same size that they've had on the website. These here, the Prosecco colors. And so they sent these instead. So sticky notes are always really useful. These little pads I really love. This one is a little bit more shiny. So I got one in a previous box, and this one is more of like a linen. And it says message here, and it's more of a linen type fabric here, whereas this is more, feels more papery, but it's definitely shiny. The one in this box, very specific. It does give you prompts, whereas this one was a little bit more empty. But this one says question, evidence, and conclusion. So I can still absolutely use these. They're perforated, so you can easily just tear them out. These I can absolutely use really for any note taking, but I don't know if I would actually use it for question, evidence, and conclusion. But these dividers, I've had some in previous boxes, and I'm not gonna lie, I sold them, gave them away, gifted them, I don't really remember, because they didn't work very well for me personally. But they created these, and I saw on their reel they were using a white pen to write on them. I don't have a white pen, so I can't try that for you, but the surface is not, it's a very textured, toothy surface, so I don't know how that would work. And on their reel, they had these kind of clipped onto their page like that. And so it's a divider. This one says priorities. I like the concept. This is a very thick plastic. It's not vellum. It's a very, very thick, rigid plastic. So it should be very durable, but it is also a little bit bulky for a thin ring system. But if you have other planners, it might work really well. I don't have a pen to, unless it's in this thing, I don't have a pen to test on here for you. But I think I'm going to keep these for a short while and just kind of mess around with them. So you have priorities, you have to-dos with little check boxes over here, and then you have this week. This I actually really like because I would totally use this for my menu because I meal plan every single week. So these are, this is a linen color. I like this little sheet thingy that they kind of created. So you can, like, when you're doing your videos and stuff, you can, you can totally, like, it doesn't match up perfectly, but that's okay. But you can totally, like, show the color of the actual product. But these are all the same color. It's linen is what the color is. These are stuck together. There you go. Okay. So here's the color of the stickers. And they're just a really, really thin, transparent, very, very thin sticker. So they'll be really nice for, like, your monthly calendars or any of your other things that you need to kind of highlight. All right, let's go ahead and open up these pens. Oh, pencil pouch. I forgot this. They did show this too, and I actually really like it. So this mesh thing, it's not sewn on the top or adhered to the top. And so you just got to be careful with it. But they have, like, this cute little insert. I think that they have other inserts, different colors, on the website as well. But this I actually really like. This would work really well in, like, a work tote. And then they have a little divider on this side. It's like the PCV plasticky type material. And then this is more of, like, a fabric type material. So I like this. I'll definitely use that. All right, pens. So I'm no expert at these cloth and paper boxes. So I don't know if there is somewhere where it says what type of pens I'm about to try out or if I just read it. Here, this is what it is. There it is. Okay, so this says milk tea highlighter pens. So that's these. Ooh. Oh. If you really like pink, this is really cool. Okay. So that's a really, like, flat type of highlighter. Zebra Sarasa Speedy. This one, this is an 05. I don't have great lettering capabilities, but that one's a nice pen. It writes really smoothly. And that's an 0.5. I said 0.5, but I meant to say 0.5. The Zebra Sarasa Gel Dark Blue Ink. I actually have this one. This is, I think, part of their vintage collection. Okay, so it's a really nice, like, blue-black. Uni Mechanical Pencil Black Barrel. Oh, I love pencils, y'all. And this is a really nice, this is a 0.5. A lot of the pencils I have are 0.7s, so this I actually really like. This I am definitely going to use, like, a lot. Micron Graphic Needle Pen Blue, excuse me, black ink. This is, what size is this comparative to? It looks really broad. Oh yeah, that's broad. I'm saying 0.8 because here it says gen.0.8080. Probably has nothing to do with the size, but my microns, 8 micron, and it's pretty close. This is actually, I think it's a little bit darker of an ink, and I think it's a little bit more bold. So overall, out of the box, I actually like all of this stuff. I will probably not use this just because of the color that it is, but these are all definitely keepers for me. This is a surprising box because I'm actually going to keep almost everything, whereas some other stuff I don't usually keep. The dashboard I will probably not use. Note-taking inserts I will absolutely use. Undecided on the stickers. I'll probably use them in my monthly spreads for events. Clear index tabs. Love the idea. I need to find a pen that writes on them very well. Very well. And then the pen pouch. Absolutely going to use. I don't usually use correction tape, but I'll definitely keep it in case I need to use it. And then this I really like as well. And then the gray sticky notes. So overall, extremely, extremely happy with this box. I am very happy that I got this month's subscription for the box. So if you have any questions, let me know and tell me what your favorite item was out of this box. And thanks for hanging out with me. Appreciate it.